In this video, we start to look at circuits that have current sources in them and then use mesh current analysis to solve the circuits. So in this first problem that we have here, here's a 3-amp current source over on the right side of the circuit, and then you can see we have a voltage source over on the left. Now before we start this problem, let me just back up and give you the answer for I3 for this problem that we did last video. Turns out that the book I took this problem out of only asked for I3, so when I solved it, I only solved for mesh current I3. So if you solve for mesh current I3, you should get an answer of minus 5 amps. So remember what a minus in front of a current means. It means that the direction is actually opposite of what was defined. So in mesh current method, if you come up with a negative answer for one of your mesh currents, it just means that the mesh current is really flowing the other direction. So, you know, I had this defined as clockwise. Really, I3 is going counterclockwise. So there's 5 amps flowing through this 6 ohm resistor, and it's going right to left. Okay? So let's go back to this circuit here. So what's different about this circuit is that it has a current source, and we haven't solved a problem with mesh current method with the current source. So we're going to see, or start to see, how to handle that with this problem. So I've set up the problem. Here's mesh current I1, here's mesh current I2, and I put in the polarities for the resistor voltages based on those mesh current directions. So I'm going to start off here writing a KVL equation for mesh current I1. Okay, so we're going to get minus 20 plus 5I1 plus 10I1 minus 10I2 equals 0. Okay, so we just went ahead and wrote our KVL equation just like we've done in previous problems. However, when we get over to this mesh current I2, where the current source is, before we blindly go about writing a KVL equation, let's remember what this current source symbol is telling us. And to do that, you have to remember the voltage current definition of an ideal current source. Remember, an ideal current source has the rated amount of current, which is 3 amps in this case, flowing in the direction of the arrow of the symbol, which is down in this case, no matter what the voltage across it is. So you see, we know this symbol tells us that there's 3 amps flowing down, okay, right in this part of the circuit. Well, I2 is just something that I arbitrarily define, so I can go ahead and write equations and, you know, solve for the values. So if I have a mesh current defined only through a current source, well, that mesh current must equal the current source value. And since I picked I2 going in the same direction, well, I2 is just 3 amps. See, you don't write a KVL equation when you have a single mesh current through a current source. It's just that mesh current will equal the current source value. Now, if the arrow for this 3 amps was pointing up instead of down, and I still had I2 going clockwise, well, then the only difference would be is that I2 would be equal to minus 3 amps, because the direction of the arrow of this independent current source would tell me the actual direction. So if I pick a mesh current going against that, well, it's just minus, because the mesh current's really going the other way. Okay, so now, you know, to finish this problem, all you would need to do is just plug in 3 amps here and solve for I1. In fact, if you do that, you should get an I1 equal to 3 1/3 amps. Okay, so the main point of this lecture was to see how you handle this current source, okay? Now, you can have circuits where the current source is towards the middle of the circuit or in the middle of two meshes, and you have two mesh currents defined through it. Well, when you have two mesh currents defined through a current source, that's what's called a supermesh. And we're going to spend the next couple of videos talking about a supermesh.